There are so many things to do and see in Macon, Georgia. People traveling between Atlanta and Florida often overlook this quintessential southern city, but they probably just don't know how happening it really is. There are very good reasons why Macon has earned itself the nickname the Heart of Georgia. Not only is it centrally located in the state, but it also boasts a rich history that dates back to prehistoric times and moves through the Civil War and Civil Rights eras. If you're not that familiar with Macon, it might be difficult to know where to begin. So join us as we explore the numerous sites, attractions, events, and festivals that make Macon, Georgia a must-visit destination. Tubman Museum. The Tubman Museum, named after the influential American abolitionist and political activist Harriet Tubman, is a well-curated and popular museum that shares African American history and culture. It's notable for being the largest museum of its kind in the American Southeast. The Tubman Museum makes a powerful statement about Black history at a time when the world needs to hear it most. Famous and historically significant Black men and women are celebrated here, and their stories are told in such a way that everyone can grasp their significance. You can learn about military heroes like Crispus Attucks, the first Black man to lay down his life in the American Revolution, Rodney Davis, Macon's one and only Medal of Honor recipient, Otis Redding, famed Black entertainer, and Reverend Pearly Brown, the blind singer-songwriter and guitarist. The museum also features several exhibits that used to be on display at the now-defunct Georgia Music Hall of Fame. Amerson River Park. It was at one time the Macon Water Authority's water treatment facility, but when the plant was destroyed in a flood in 1994, it was relocated. The area was then converted into this gorgeous green space, complete with hiking trails, bike paths, and playgrounds. The park reopened in 2015 after undergoing several significant upgrades. In addition to the features we already mentioned, the park also offers breathtaking views of the Ocmulgee River, several picnic areas, and canoe launches. Hey, if you're enjoying this video so far, be sure to give it a like and subscribe to Viewcation if you haven't already. And stick around to learn a little about the region's First Nation inhabitants. Hay House. The Hay House was built in 1860 and owned by William Johnston. When it was constructed, it was the pinnacle of innovation and modernity. It featured contemporary amenities such as hot and cold running water, heating and cooling systems, and even walk-in closets. To put that into perspective, even the White House didn't have all those comforts at the time. Johnston earned his riches in the real estate, insurance, and banking industries. Today, the Hay House is owned by the National Historic Trust. It's open to the public and has been carefully preserved as a museum. Guided tours of the house and grounds are held regularly for folks looking for a bit more in-depth history of the opulent mansion. For an additional fee, you can also see the upper floors of the house, which we feel is well worth it. Ocmulgee Mounds National Historic Park. This park celebrates the 17,000 years of continuous human habitation of the region. It also serves as a memorial of the unique relationship between the native peoples and natural resources of the area throughout the ages. Native Americans first settled here back in the Paleo-Indian period to hunt Ice Age mammals for their pelts and meat. Multiple cultures have called this land their home for millennia, with each leaving its own unique mark on history. Around 900 AD, the Mississippian people arrived here and started constructing mounds for the higher-ranking members of their tribe. Today, these mounds remain virtually unaltered for visitors to see and appreciate. The Allman Brothers Band Museum at the Big House. The Allman Brothers Band was formed in 1969 by legendary guitarist and songwriter Duane Allman. After the band was offered a recording contract with Capricorn Records, they found their way to Macon. There, Duane and his bandmates Greg Allman, Dickie Betts, Barry Oakley, Butch Trucks, and J-Mo fine-tuned their signature sound, which blended blues, jazz, rock, and country to form an entirely new genre of music. In 1970, Barry Oakley and Linda, his wife, rented a gorgeous Tudor-style house out on Vineville Avenue. Duane and his brother Greg then moved in, forming one big happy family. That house, which is affectionately called the Big House, became the epicenter of the band's activities during these formative years. Today, the Big House has been fully restored and has been transformed into a museum that celebrates the Allman Brothers Band's history. Guests can see the band members' original guitars, musical gear, clothing, pictures, posters, gold records, and a ton of memorabilia. St. Joseph's Catholic Church. This historic church is beautiful inside and out. Cathedrals this beautiful in the U.S. are quite rare, especially in towns as small as Macon. It took 14 years to construct and was christened in 1903. It's adorned with 60 wildly intricate stained glass windows, massive marble columns, a pipe organ, white stone carvings, and bronze bells that ring out three times daily. Sunday Mass is 8:30 a.m., 11 a.m., and 5 p.m. every Sunday, but you can swing by for a tour any day of the week. Museum of Arts and Sciences. This museum started off as just a single rented room featuring a few articles of historical significance. Today, it's a state-of-the-art 50,000 square foot facility sitting on a 14-acre campus. The museum celebrates the intersection of the sciences and arts through numerous interactive exhibits that are designed to stimulate curiosity while instilling in guests a passion for learning. There's also a full-dome planetarium, a mini-zoo featuring over 70 live animals, an interactive discovery house, beautiful nature trails, and an auditorium. After spending the day learning about art and science, swing by the museum store to pick up a souvenir. Admission price is reasonable, and discounts are offered for children, military personnel, the elderly, and students. The Cannonball House. This Civil War-era house earned its name for the cannonball that still resides there. It's a great spot to take a guided tour and learn about local history. At the Battle of Dunlap Hill, the cannonball in question became lodged in the home of Judge Asa Holt. The person who shot it was William Butler Johnson, who at the time was the treasurer of the Confederacy. If that name sounds familiar, Johnson was the person who owned the hay house we mentioned earlier. When he fired his cannon, the cannonball bounced off one of the house's columns before passing through a parlor wall where it landed at the bottom of the stairs. It can still be seen sitting there today. You can even take a selfie with it. When you make your visit, make sure you visit the original servants' quarters and kitchen around back. Douglas Theater. This theater is one of just a few historic theaters built, designed, and operated by an African American. Charles Douglas was the owner and proprietor of this theater, and for all intents and purposes, he was a man ahead of his time. Visitors to his theater could see three or four short films on its golden screen. Traveling vaudeville performers also frequently put on a show. Some black entertainers that have performed at the theater are James Brown, Duke Ellington, Little Richard, and Otis Redding, to name a few. When television sets became common in American homes in the mid-20th century, theaters like the Douglas Theater struggled to draw in patrons. Because of this, they were forced to close in 1972. But the doors didn't stay closed for long. The theater reopened after being renovated and upgraded in 1997. Out front, you'll find a Walk of Fame that recognizes some of Georgia's most significant musical stars. Macon's Annual Festival. Every September, Macon hosts their annual Ocmulgee Indian Celebration, which is one of the largest Native American gatherings in the Southeast, with more than 200 dancers, storytellers, and craftsmen coming out to celebrate the Ocmulgee people's rich history and culture. In October, the city hosts the Central Georgia Greek Festival. Attendees can immerse themselves in all things Greek, like Greek music, dancing, food, and taking tours of the beautiful Holy Cross Greek Orthodox Church. The Macon International Cherry Blossom Festival is held in March. You can enjoy the natural beauty of more than 300,000 Yoshino cherry trees in full bloom as they help bring in spring. The festival also features numerous exhibits, concerts, events, and vendors. Georgia Sports Hall of Fame. This sports museum and Hall of Fame is the nation's largest state sports museum. The 43,000 square foot facility houses more than 3,000 artifacts dating back to the early days of Georgia's existence as a state. Immediately as you walk through the museum's old school ticket booths and see the lit brick columns in the museum's rotunda, you'll feel as if you stepped into another time. Visitors can learn the history of sports in Georgia by exploring 14,000 square feet of exhibit space and a Hall of Fame hallway that honors and celebrates the storied careers of more than 400 inductees. Now it's time to hear from you. Is there anything we missed in Macon, Georgia that we should know about? Let us know in the comments section below. And before you go, make sure you give this video a like and subscribe to Viewcation if you haven't already. Click the bell icon to stay updated on all our latest content.